Hi everyone, this is Maverick Paul, the chemistry guru. Now in this video, we want to discuss the concept on salt hydrolysis. Now if I consider a neutralization reaction where my acid and base will react to give me salt and water, and since this process is called neutralization, does it mean that my salt is always neutral? Now if you think that since this is a neutralization reaction, so therefore the product has to be neutral, actually this is a misconception. Now the nature of the salt can be acidic, can be neutral, can be alkaline. It actually depends on the nature of the acid and base that forms the salt. So in salt hydrolysis, what we want to determine is whether the salt is acidic, neutral or alkaline. The concept involving this is actually very simple. By looking at the nature of the acid and the base that forms this particular salt, I can figure out the nature of this salt. So let us take a look at some examples. Before we jump in and look at these examples, there's some fundamental ideas that we want to talk about. Now remember our dissociation of our weak acids and strong acids. Now weak acid will dissociate in solution to give me a weak conjugate base. My weak base will dissociate in solution to give me a weak conjugate acid. My strong acid will dissociate in solution to give me a counter ion form which is neutral. A strong base will dissociate in solution to give me a counter ion which is neutral. We need this concept, which is very fundamental in ionic equilibrium, for us to figure out salt hydrolysis. Now the first example we have is sodium chloride. So what we do is we split the salt into the cation and the anion, and we figure out what is the nature of the cation based on the acid or base that forms it, and we figure out the nature of my anion based on the nature of the acid or base that forms it. So my sodium chloride, of course, I can split it to Na plus and Cl minus. Na plus is formed from sodium hydroxide. Cl minus, it comes from HCl. So this salt is formed from the acid-base reaction between NaOH and HCl. Then from the nature of my base, NaOH, we know this is a strong base. Strong base counter ion form is neutral. So Na plus is neutral. So we are making use of this concept here. Strong base will give me a counter ion form, which is neutral. Then what we have is my HCl gives me my Cl minus. HCl is a strong acid, counter ion form is neutral. So in this case, strong acid to give me something that is neutral, the concept is here. So my HCl will give me a neutral Cl minus. Then if I combine these two together, my cation is neutral, my anion is also neutral. So if both of these species are neutral, then obviously this salt has to be neutral. And therefore, the pH of the solution will be equal to 7. Now let's look at another example, CH3CO- and Na+. Now what we do is we split this into the cation and anion, and this CH3CO- is formed from CH3COH. Na+ comes from sodium hydroxide. So this salt is formed from the neutralization between this acid and this base. And the nature of my CH3COH, it is a weak acid. Now remember, a weak acid will give me a weak conjugate base. So the nature of this CH3CO minus, it is a conjugate base. Then my NaOH, it is a strong base. So a strong base, my counter ion form is neutral. Again, this concept is here, a strong base will give me a counter ion that is neutral. So what we end up with is I have a conjugate base. My anion is a conjugate base. My cation is something neutral. So obviously the pH of the solution will follow this CH3CO minus because it is a base. So I would expect the solution to be alkaline, and I will expect the pH of the solution to be more than 7. So this salt is an alkaline salt. All right, we have one more example, NH4 plus Cl minus. NH4 plus comes from ammonia. Cl minus comes from HCl. Now, ammonia, it is a weak base. A weak base will give me a weak conjugate acid. So NH4 plus is my conjugate acid. Again, the concept is here. Weak base will give me a weak conjugate acid. And my HCl is a strong acid. Strong acid counter ion form is neutral. Then this concept, we have it here. Strong acid counter ion form is neutral. So if my cation is a conjugate acid, my anion is neutral. So of course, the pH of the solution will follow this NH4 plus because it is a conjugate acid. So what we expect is the solution to be acidic, and of course the pH of the solution will be less than 7. So you notice actually salt hydrolysis is very simple. It's nothing more than identifying one of my ions, whether the cation or the anion is a conjugate acid of a weak base or a conjugate base of a weak acid. Alright, I hope you find this video useful. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel for more weekly video lessons. That's all we have for this video. I'll see you next time.